In this video lecture, we'll take a look at another useful application of while looping, which is type-safe input. This is simply the checking of user input data in the loop to ensure that input is of the expected data type. Okay, let's get started. Recall that when we first introduced the notion of user input in programs, we said that it made our programs more general and hence more useful, but it did introduce the new problem of potentially bad user input data. We've already seen that by using the next methods of the scanner class, we can read user input of any data type. But as we know, human users can be very unpredictable. Sometimes they rush through things, sometimes they don't bother reading the directions or the data prompts very closely, and sometimes they just fumble finger or misspell whatever they're typing. Does any of this sound at all familiar to you from personal experience? Let's suppose your program is trying to read an int value from the user using scanner's nextInt method. But suppose your user instead enters something that can't be interpreted as an integer. What happens then? Well, usually something like an input mismatch exception will be generated by your code. We haven't talked about exceptions in Java yet, and may not get to this subject in detail at all in this course. But in simple terms, exceptions are bad news. They're an indication that something very wrong or unanticipated has happened in your code, and then your code freezes up and doesn't know what to do next. Figuratively speaking, your program barfs or coughs up a lung and just stops in its tracks. Some sort of exception error message will be displayed, which is ugly for the user to see, and frankly, it's just unprofessional because something bad has happened that we didn't anticipate or design for. Because user input is inherently unpredictable, these types of things truly become a defensive programming issue, which is the downside to the upside of introducing input-output to our programs. Here's a simple example which demonstrates the problem. This small, simple program on the left is simply setting up a scanner object and using it to prompt the user for their age, read it in using nextInt, and then echo it back out. This program is assuming that the user will enter an int value, but doesn't really come out and say so in this prompt. As long as the user does enter some whole number, as we see in this first output on the right, everything is fine and the program works as expected. But let's suppose that now the user is some very precise engineering or math major and enters 21.0 like this, with a decimal point. But it's still technically an age, right? Or suppose the user is some little kid, for whom that extra half year really matters, and they enter, say, a 7.5. Well, any number having a decimal point is no longer an integer but a floating point number, and thus cannot be interpreted as the expected int data type. So the Java program throws out this input mismatch exception error and spews out all this detail in green, which is called a stack trace, and details the calling sequence which led to the failure. You might have seen something like this already working on your prior programs, but for any normal non-CS person, this is probably going to elicit some sort of "what the hell?" reaction, very disconcerting to a user. Or in this next output example, suppose the user is a bit more verbal and enters their age as a string like this. The same type of exception error and error messages will result. In both these last two error cases, the common problem is that the user entered something other than the expected int data type. To see a quick demo of this taking place, please take a moment now to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough video for looping while type unsafe.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. So now that we've seen what the type safe problem represents, here's how we'd go about addressing it. Before we read any piece of data, we'd like to peek ahead and check whether it's going to match the expected input type. To do this, we'll use the various Hasnext methods of the scanner class, which we'll look at in a moment. There are Hasnext methods to handle all the expected primitive data types, and they look ahead to scout out the next data's type and report back some Boolean true-false status. As you might expect, we can then use a while loop to keep rechecking until the data matches the expected type. In this case, the not of the hasNext result becomes our while loop's continuation condition. As long as it's true that the next piece of data is not of the expected type, we would continue while looping. So once the previewed data type of the next piece of data matches the expected type, we know that we can safely read that piece of data and continue on. But if our scouting report tells us that the next piece of data does not match the expected data type, as long as this continuation condition up here is true, we flush that next input by reading it anyway as a string using NextLine. We dump it on the ground and ignore it. Then we come back around in our while loop to reprompt the user and try again. Using the approach outlined here, we can keep dogging the user until they finally enter some data of the expected data type. Here are the various Hasnext methods of the scanner class. This dot 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 here is merely intended as a placeholder for these various primitive data types. And notice that they all have a leading capital. Once again, you may notice that the one missing method is for the char data type. But notice that we can use this last Hasnext method for generic string input. And of course, one single char is nothing but the first character of any set of user keystrokes. Every one of these methods returns a single Boolean value, which will be true only if the next piece of input data can be interpreted as the specified data type, or else false otherwise. So we can use these methods to peer ahead and preview the next piece of user input in the scanner input stream. Scanner also provides for this next line method, which simply reads in everything remaining on the input line as a string. Remember that string is essentially the most generic kind of input because any set of keystrokes we can imagine can be interpreted as a string. So here then is the pseudocode for handling type-safe input. First, we prompt the user for whatever input that we desire. Then we enter this while loop and we continue looping as long as the input does not match the data type specifically requested. If that's the case, we repeat the loop body by flushing the input by reading it in using NextLine and then ignoring it, or figuratively dropping it on the ground. If we neglect to do this step, this call to NextLine, we can wind up looping endlessly. Then we reprompt for the input and return to the top of the loop to once again check if the input now matches the expected data type. If it still doesn't, we make another iteration of this loop. But if the input does finally match the expected data type, then this loop condition fails, we exit this while loop, and then we can safely read what is finally known to be good data of the proper data type. Let's now see how to implement this type-safe checking pseudocode. This example is exactly the same code as before, except that we have now implemented type-safe input checking. Note that what we've added is simply this while loop in between the original data prompt on line 26 and the original data read on line 36. We've just spliced it in between those two lines. Now we are simply looking ahead first using hasNext int to see if the next age input is of the expected int data type. The negative or not of that check now becomes our loop continuation condition. If the next age input is not of the expected type, we simply flush it by reading it in as this garbage string and simply not doing anything with it. We reprompt the user with a little stronger message and come back around to check again. Again, hasNext int isn't actually reading any age data, it's just scouting ahead and reporting back to us. Once we finally know that the next age input is of the desired int type, we exit the loop and know that we can safely read in the age as an int and then echo it back out. To see a quick demo of this taking place, please take a moment now to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough video for loopingwhile-typesafe.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. Now, handling type-safe input in a GUI context, for example using JOption pane, is a completely different situation. Here, we don't have the same look-ahead capabilities as does the scanner class, so we have to structure our code differently. In this code example on the right, what we're trying to do is read in an age as an integer using JOption pane's showInputDialog method, then echo it back out again using JOption pane's showMessageDialog method, and we'll demonstrate the age is in fact a numeric int by performing this increment operation upon it. Recall that we introduced JOption pane when we talked about input output, So please go back and refresh your memory on it if you need the reminder. We said that the key thing about using GUI dialogs such as JOptionPane for user input was that all user input is returned as a string type, such as this age_str variable, and it must be converted using one of the wrapper class parse methods, as seen here. But now we no longer have those hasNext methods available to us, and if the wrapper class conversion fails, a different kind of exception will be generated. This implementation relies upon what's called a try-catch block in Java, which allows for the graceful interception of exceptions, and possibly some needed corrective action. By intercepting an exception error, rather than our program crashing, we can instead reprompt the user for new data as many times as needed, using this outer while loop. Exception handling such as this will be fully covered in the follow-on class. This is just an advanced preview. However, you will need to do something like this when handling GUI input in a current or upcoming program assignment, and you will use code that looks almost identical to this. For a more detailed explanation and demonstration of this specific example, please finish up by viewing the short code walkthrough video for looping while typesafe GUI.java, which you'll find in the usual place. You'll want to open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along. Okay then, that concludes this discussion on performing type-safe input checking using while loops.